Hello everyone, welcome back to another video on Aspen Tech channel, and this video is basically a theoretical portion where we will be discussing the tips for the successful simulation. Obviously, we have done a lot of simulations, like we have done the simulation of heat exchangers, reactors, distillation columns, extractive distillations, then we have done various process flow sheetings, but what are the general tips after getting all this knowledge? So there are three different steps. Number one is pre-simulation step, which we need to do before doing the simulation. Then obviously the simulation steps and the post-simulation steps. So we have divided the overall segment of the simulation process into these three possible steps. So number one is the pre-simulation or planning. Now there are different tasks which we need to do in the planning of the simulation or the pre-simulation process. Number one is to set the goals of the process. Obviously, once we have defined that we will be needing, for example, 99.98% purity of ethanol in the system or 1000 tons per day of a certain product in the system, then obviously we have to set these clear and specific goals in the system. Then we need to take paper, pencil or pen, and we need to draw the overall schematic of the system to avoid any flaw in the system, because arrangement of the equipments, pressure of the system, the temperatures of the system, if we have some rough idea about it and if we can further list down all the possible parameters and we can sketch a process, then it is easy to visualize it and it is easy to start with. Then examine the input data, whichever the data you have available to start the simulation. Is it enough for the simulation? Like we have already discussed degree of freedom analysis, that to define a stream in the system, we need temperature, we need pressure, we need flow rate, we need composition. So all the given data is available or not. So we have to identify it. Then obviously we need to identify which of the components, chemicals are involved in the system. Can we go with the simple or conventional system like in Aspen Plus, or we need some hypothetical or pseudo components in the process. So this identification is also necessary before doing the simulation. Obviously, once you have simulated various processes, you can automatically classify all of these in the list. Then selection of suitable thermodynamic property package. This is a very, very critical task in the process, because if you select the wrong property package, all of your results are inadequate or unreliable in the system. Like for hydrocarbons, if you select an activity coefficient like NRTL, obviously you are going to create a mess, or your results will be inaccurate in the system. So right selection of the thermodynamic property package is key to success. Then obtain the plant data. If you are taking the information, or if you are simulating an existing plant, or verifying the lab results, because if you see in research especially, you have to validate the simulated model data with the experimental data. So obviously the experimental data or the plant data you need to start with, or at the end you need to cross verify it, and that data once matches, or I can say once experimental data matches with the simulated data, obviously there is a consistency, and once there is a consistency, then we can proceed or with the simulation model, and then we can do some changes like optimization, sensitivity analysis and so on. Avoid applying the program to estimate properties if possible by entering data for the proprietary materials. So obviously you need to provide all the data like binary input information and so on, something information like that, and then make some preliminary calculations in the simulator. Like if you have a complex plant and you have some initial information, like you have the information of compressor, you have the information of mixer, then these blocks can be solved. But if you have a heat exchanger and that heat exchanger is using a utility, then you can simulate it as well. But if a heat exchanger's cold or hot stream is coming from the process which is coming in the list of like 7th or 8th, then obviously it is hard to simulate in the start, but obviously once you get to the simulation steps, you have to solve it. So this is the overall pre-simulation steps, which you need to do on paper, sketching, then selection, then identification and so on. Simulation buildup. This is the critical parameter or the critical task which you need to do. All of the efforts will be in vain of post and pre if you do not make this one correct. So stay focused and start slowly. Build a model very slowly in the system. Connect the equipment one by one. First, connect the pump, then mixer, then heater, then cooler. So one by one, connect it, simulate it, end it. And make sure that the units which you are dealing with remain consistent. If you are using English units, then accordingly the consistent units should be used. If you are using SI units or metric units, accordingly it should remain the consistent. If there is inconsistency in the units, obviously it will lead to incorrect results in the system. Avoid connecting recycle streams. Obviously, first one should be a simpler process. Like instead of heat exchangers, you should use heater or cooler for the particular application. Instead of using the rigorous reactors, you should use the shortcut reactors. Similarly for the distillation column. Because first you need to develop a process and then you will have an identification where to place which equipment. Like you have to place CSTR or PFR or rigorous. That is the second step of this simulation buildup. Specify outcomes first. For example, that in case of pump, you know the information of pump's curve, but instead of applying pump's curve at the first, initially just give outlet pressure and efficiency value and then proceed with it. And once you have simulated without recycle, then you can give the remaining information and simulate it. Because you have to first simulate the process and check accuracy of the simulation. Then you can further complex it slowly and steadily. This one in your mind that you should stay focused and build a model slowly. For example, for the columns, you should start with the ideal stages whose plate efficiency is 1. There is no rocket science in it. But once you are going to complex systems or you are building the model and developing complex systems, then you can definitely choose the realistic mercury plate efficiency. Similarly, once there are convergence issues or you need to change the convergence method, then you can obviously shift to some other method in the system. But first one is to keep the process as simple as possible and you have to stay focused, revise and recycle. Obviously, first you need to apply the system and run it and get the required results. If you're not getting the required results, first get all these results without recycle. Once you have got your results nearly or approximately closer to what you should have got, then you can connect recycle one by one. First connect the recycle, then simulate it, then connect the recycle and then simulate it. And please make sure that you are making the notes and you are documenting each and every step so that if you have done a mistake in any part, then you can simply go back and check it and rectify your problem. Post simulation steps. Obviously, these are the important steps because once you have simulated the process, you need to check that even after the recycle, you have got your purities right, you have got your recycle flow rates right, you have got heat duties right. If these are not realistic, then you need to obviously alter the process. Similarly, if your process is not converging, then you should identify the weakest part or the loose link in your simulation and solve it. But in some cases, what some people do, they lose the value of the tolerance. This is not correct method. That's why I have highlighted it as red, that losing a tolerance to force convergence can lead to seriously flawed results because at the moment you can get your required result. However, when you are doing a research work or you are doing a design work for a firm, obviously that will lead to your incorrect results and incorrect calculations. Then perform sensitivity analysis. Obviously, you all know what is sensitivity analysis, the effect of a parameter on the other parameter, independent variable on the dependent variable. You have to vary the inputs. And if the sensitivity analysis shows that a certain impact of, for example, the temperature have an effect on the process, critical effect on the process, then obviously you can identify the parameters by sensitivity analysis and then you can apply the control accordingly in the system. So perform sensitivity analysis by varying inputs. If the result seems to be very sensitive to inputs, then the process control may be difficult. Obviously, you have to apply higher controls like cascade control types and so on, different control applications in the system. And last step, obviously, you need to save the file and the simulation file and accordingly the documentation in some logical drive, like in E drive, the drives which you want to save so that your data remains the save in the save mode. And obviously, once you learn some new thing, obviously you should document it, because once you have learned something and once you have documented, and if you face the problem in the future, then you can go back to your notes and you can rectify the problem. So that's how basically our simulation goes on. There are pre-simulation, simulation, build-up and post-simulation steps. And we have been doing approximately the same in our all 92 videos which have been uploaded on this channel for you. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel Aspen Tech. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.